Hey everyone, I'm Matt Sakai. I'm a video gaming enthusiast and streamer on the Facebook gaming platform, and today I'm going to talk to you about Hunt Showdown, which is one of my favorite first-person shooters at the moment. It is one of the most unique games that I've ever seen in this category because it has both a PvE and a PvP element to it. While not as popular as a lot of other first-person shooters out there, it is starting to build up at the moment. They've had a lot of new add-ons to the game, some additional patches, and a lot of streamers are picking up on it as well. With that popularity is coming a number of new players to the game, and there's quite a significant learning curve to Hunt Showdown. So this video is not going to be advanced gameplay or how to be the best aim person or the best loadout. If you play the game for any significant period of time, you probably won't get much from this. It's very much a beginner 101 kind of video. Couple of key things that new people to the game tend to make mistakes with all the time that will help them enjoy their intro a lot more, pick up the game a lot better, and have a lot more fun. So with that in mind, bear with me. Hopefully you find this interesting, and if so, feel free to come and follow along the stream or comment below. What I'm going to start with is how sound intensive Hunt Showdown really is. Yes, with Warzone, with Fortnite, with any other shooting game, you can, to a certain extent, hear people shooting off in the distance or fighting, kind of try and find your way there and third party in. But Hunt is designed completely around the sound, not just in terms of the guns, but every mechanic of the game. There's a difference between a running hunter, a walking hunter, and a crouching hunter. Walking through the bushes, rustling leaves, water, cracking branches, each of the zombies makes a different noise. So being highly aware of how much sound you're making makes a huge difference at first. People who aren't familiar with this element of it will typically run in with a gun of some kind in their first few games, shoot the first few zombies that they see, give away their location, and be massacred by more experienced hunters. And this is where we tend to lose a lot of beginners. So in terms of the sound, you want to have a really good headset. You want to have the sound effects up a decent amount without blowing out your eardrums, and be aware of how much you are producing. As I mentioned, everything does make a different sound. The guns are a good place to start if you come into the Romero, pretty standard shotgun to start with, and come into the 3D view here. You can hear exactly what this gun sounds like if someone was to fire this next to you. And then, given that the map is a 1x1 kilometer map, you can actually zoom out. So if I was 300 meters away from this person and they fired the same gun, you can still hear that, and I can tell how far away, what type of weapon they're using, and what direction they're in based on that sound. So gunfire is obviously the most easy way to give away your location. The bigger the gun, the bigger the bang, the further away it can be heard. But there's all sorts of other things, as I mentioned, and some of the easiest ones to get tripped up on are the PvE element. As I mentioned, Hunt is PvE predominantly, so the idea is to go and find clues and hunt down one of three different demon bosses. While you're doing this, you're going to come across a significant amount of zombies. There's all types of different zombies, from your basic grunts through to armored, hives, immolators, and so on and so forth. All of them are explained in this little monstorium that you've got here, and you get used to the various ways that you can fight them. There's a different trigger radius on each of them. Immolators and hellhounds, for example, have quite a large trigger radius. Not only is this dangerous to you because they will give away your location, but you can learn to utilize this sound to actually identify where other hunters are. If you're looking across a field and you suddenly see an immolator charge over to the right, they only trigger on other hunters. They don't trigger on other zombies or anything like that, so you can use that to identify where people are. So it's a give and take relationship. Another one that's really interesting is water devils. They exist in the water, they make a clicking naturally, it sounds kind of like a predator, but they only rile up and start to hiss and shriek when someone touches the water. So if you hear that sound effect, you know that someone close enough to you has touched the water to trigger one of these water devils. Really useful to be able to utilize these sound effects. With that in mind, there is a specific way to deal with each of these different types of zombies, and I won't outline them all because that would take too long and take away from some of the fun of the game, but you will learn it, and really brings into effect how useful almost every item in the game is. I'm going to branch on, continuing that PvE element, to the bosses. There are three bosses, the Assassin, the Butcher, and the Spider. These are just your big, standard type of boss. You'll find them in one of the different areas of the map after you've found enough clues. The Assassin causes significant bleeding and teleports around quite a lot. It's very hard to lock down. The Butcher, really big, strong, a lot of health, does a lot of fire damage. The Spider, quite quick, one of the creepiest ones they've made. It's actually a split open, inverted person with some extra legs, and there's a head in the face, and it does a significant amount of poison damage. There is a specific way to deal with each of these, but one thing, again, focusing on Beginner 101 that you want to keep in mind is trying to keep that noise down. It will take you a lot of shots and a lot of time to kill some of these bosses to begin with, so if you're just firing away and going crazy, you are going to give away your location and hunters will swarm on you instantly. You'll end up getting killed, you'll lose your bounty, and you've kind of lost the entire game at that point. So really want to keep the noise down. Melee weapons can be found around the map, axes, hammers, pitchforks. These are typically the best way to start with, and you'll learn more as you go. This kind of brings into the PvP element. So the PvP of this game comes into the fact that there's either one or two of these bosses in each map, and each boss drops two trophies when they're killed. Only one person or one team of people can leave with these trophies. So you can either play as an individual, in duos or trios, and there can be a maximum of 12 players in each map. Sometimes they're not full lobbies, so you may have less, but you may have up to 12, and you never know exactly how many hunters are in there. So it really is a guessing game, and it keeps you on edge the whole time, or at least you should be if you don't want to get sniped in the head. With that in mind, you can get taken out any point by these hunters. There are certain guns that can shoot through walls with what's called long ammo, and there's explosives and all sorts of things. And that brings us into the equipment. So with the equipment, there's a variety of different guns you can utilize. They have done a great job of balancing this though. The beginner guns like the Winnie rifle, which is the first thing you'll start with, the Springfield sniper, and the basic shotgun, they're just as good as the advanced guns. You don't need an advanced gun to be a good player in this game. They all work on a pretty similar mechanic. You find what works for you and you have fun with it. You can unlock advanced versions of each gun, as you can see in the book here, by gaining experience with a previous type. So you can see with the Winnie Marksman here, by gaining 2000 experience, I can level up this weapon. Unlocks a bit of the story, gives me some extra money to spend, and also unlocks further variants of the gun. The same thing goes for the basic equipment. So you've got your guns and then you've got your equipment. So with the gear, you've got things like healing shots, knives, firebombs, fuses. Each piece of equipment does have a use. There's many of them that don't get used very often because you only have four slots to pick equipment to take with you, so it's up to you to pick what style of hunter you want to be. But everything does have a use. Dusters, for example, will kill a zombie with one hit to the head, just like a knife will, but use significantly less stamina. And stamina is a resource that you will run out of quite consistently. So play around with the different gear. When you first start, you'll have a limited amount until you unlock them. And as you go up your bloodline, you will unlock more weapons and gear as well. So you can continue to do this until you get to top rank, which is level 100, at which point you can either prestige and reset and start it again and unlock everything again just for the bragging rights, or you can keep access to all of this and just keep playing. Be careful with your money though. Up here you have hunt dollars, so as you can see, I've got just over $8,000. Everything in the store costs money, and the more advanced guns you get, the more money they're going to cost. So if you want one of these high-end guns like the Dolch, $750 is quite expensive, and there is permadeath in this game. Whether you die to the PvE or the PvP element, your character dies, you lose all the progression you made on that particular hunter. So you can see I've got my hunters here, and all of the equipment they have will be gone as well. So that's why you can't just charge. Well, I mean, you can charge in and just guns flailing and hope for the best, but if you do, you will lose hunters left, right and center. You'll lose gear, you'll run out of money, and you'll probably get bored of the game. Have some respect for the mechanics of the game and you'll have a lot more fun. The last thing I want to touch on, and something that gets laughed at a lot in the community because the sound mechanics are so strong, is people get stuck into what's called crouch walking. So crouching is the quietest way to get around the map. It makes the least amount of noise. Not no noise, but the least amount of noise. So beginner hunters will often find themselves crouch walking all throughout the map. It makes you slower, it makes you an easier target, and when you're out in an open field, yes, you may be making less noise, but anyone within 200 meters of you with a rifle who has a decent computer and aim will take you out. And these guns, one shot to the head, you're dead, and you've just wasted 30 minutes creeping around for no good reason. So while you have to have respect for the sound mechanics of the game to enjoy it, don't overdo it. Crouch walking will just end up frustrating you more than it's worth. It's no fun just spending half an hour trying to be sneaky only to be killed at the last second. Positioning is key. Running around is sometimes better. If you run, it's a hard shot with these iron sights guns. Someone might wing you, but then you can hide, heal up, and get back into the fight, and you'll know where they shot you from. So be careful of getting stuck into crouch walking. Anyway, that's my quick tips for beginners. Beginners 101, be aware of the sound, respect it, use it where you can, learn how to fight each of the PvE zombies, be careful of the bosses, each of them does have a weakness you can exploit. Make sure you pick equipment that works for you. Just because a lot of people use the Sparks rifle doesn't mean it's the best one for you. And don't crouch walk around a lot. But hopefully if you found this useful and you get into hunts, welcome to the game. It is one of the best first-person shooters I've ever played personally, and I hope you guys enjoy it as much as I do. Again, I'm Mantikai, I'm just a video gaming enthusiast and streamer on the Facebook gaming platform. Definitely no pro, not here to tell you to get good or aim better, because if you watch any of my streams, I'm not the guy for that. There are other people you could watch, but hopefully this will help you enjoy the game a little more. Good gaming out there, guys.